All right, now we're good to go. All righty, so today we're gonna go test drive some WRXs. So we're just gonna drive to Leesburg, Virginia, to some Subaru dealership, which we have some very special connections, and we're gonna rock it. I need to get a sick, nasty picture of my car. Soupy Scoop! Oh, yes, here we are. Let's go in these front beautiful doors right here. Test drive ourselves a WRX.
Way better seats, man.
Alrighty, first impressions, Aaron.
The seats suck ass. The 2013 is way better.
I do like. Well, this isn't STI, so. But they're still not very comfortable.
They're not very buckety either. Like I still slip out of it.
In the new WRXs, the shifter is not directly up to the transmission. It's a cable shift. So that means there's less feel to it. But apparently they made it, it's the throws are 30% shorter than the hatchbacks, which are the previous models. But that could be changed with a short shifter. So I do not like the way this feels.
I get a feel of that.
It's not very connected.
Ugh. Yes. Oh, sweet.
All new Subarus come with backup cameras. Even
standard?
Yes. Even the STI has it, the BRZ has it, the WRX.
Well, I saw the STI, it's actually on the top of the little thing. Dude, it's hot as... Oh, wait, this is new. AC, bruh. How do you turn this thing on?
Auto. Yeah. And then just turn it towards cold.
All right. It's weird. That turbo kicks in, man. No turn on red.
Okay.
Air shifting sucks.
Dude, it's weird. This thing, everything's so touchy, man.
Yeah.
It is so weird.
When I first drove a Subaru, it was the same way for me. You get used to it.
I'm so used to my S10 where it's like, and then it goes.
Yep.
Oh, look at that rice. Get a picture of that rice.
Ooh, let's race the Civic. Oh man, that thing's probably so fast. Ooh, there's cambered wheels. It's not even in SI. Man. I kind of like the gauge setup. It looks pretty cool.
Yeah. Where are we going now?
Up here. Okay. It takes us to the highway. See what highway driving is like.
Yeah.
Yeah, just right here, 7.
Okay.
15, 7.
Anita's, that Mexican place is so good, Frank. You have to go there.
Oh.
It's like seriously like so good. I wonder what my dad's doing in here in town.
Please. Just this engine in our car is awesome.
Oh yeah. It does feel huge. Dude, a Mustang.
Race a brand new car against the Mustang, please.
Oh.
You've seen what they've been doing on Facebook lately.
The Mustangs, yeah. Reckon.
Oh, Mustang week.
We don't want to humiliate the Mustang.
Forget it has a sixth gear.
Oh yeah, it does. Woo, it's weird.
It's an open while you're low. RPMs are low. Yeah, that's pretty much for a cruising speed. Gas mileage.
Heck yeah. Dude, it's got some nice power.
This next exit half a mile would take that one.
dies out between 4,000 and 5,000 RPMs.
See, that's the what I was talking about, how the twin scrolls, they make power so fast, but they die fast too. Shoot, dude. Freaking Hondo. Holy.
Oh, grabby.
Make a U-turn at this light.
Okay.
Man, that was good.
It still feels better in your car, though.
Yeah, my car throws you in its seat because it's so freaking light. Oh, no, it's just... I'm very interested to see where they're going to take the FA20.
Dude, it does not, like, full lock.
It's so torquey. It's because it's got...
find a place to pull over and switch drivers.
I should have went in there.
That's all right.
Just keep going straight. See, it's because it's got a 10 to 1 compression ratio.
Thank you.
So here we have an STI. I'll check the door plate for the year, but... it's a repo. The guy that owned it before was a douchebag, blew a rod. They replaced the engine. Now it's just sitting here for sale because he did some stupid mods with some stupid tune. Well, actually, no stupid tune. So stupid no tune. And he had awful credit, but he lied on his paperwork. So they sold it to him. And then he couldn't pay for it. So he brought it in to get the engine. And then they just kept it. So
check out that Cobb.
It's got a Cobb heat shield. The downpipe is stock, so they took the exhaust back to stock. Stock turbo. Let's see.
Big old hole in the air box.
Oh, yeah. Big old. You know, that's what an intake is for, Aaron.
Dude, it might not be a stock turbo.
It looks pretty stock. I can't see it, but...
it's probably just a heat shield.
It looks like a stock turbo. Let's see this door plate. It is in crappy shape. Whoever, it's a smoker car, so that means it's even cheaper. Standing here with our salesman Frank, looking at this STI. There's Mr. Frank. So,
AKA the tank.
So, nobody at this dealership knows anything about this Subaru right here. So we're gonna have to. He wrote down the VIN. He's gonna ask his general manager, and we're gonna try to beat down this general manager on this price. His name's Hussein?
Yeah.
Well, Hussein the main? I don't know. We'll have to think us. We'll have to make him really like us, Aaron. Mm-hmm. It smells like cigs, Frank. Here, let me open this for you.
Wow.
I absolutely love it.
There you go. What is this? This. Oh shoot, that thing's broken right there too.
More money off. Oh yeah.
The lock button's broken on this side.
So how does it work if like, so I guess obviously the higher price the car you sell, the better commission you get?
I don't make commission yet.
Okay.
Oh, so hell.
But it still goes as credit. Hey, we got some hot sauce. Are you still recording?
Yeah, I am.
Okay, that's fine.
Here, oh wait, let me roll up my windows.
It's hot as balls, dude.
Yeah, I know. So, we're leaving the dealership. And, so that white STI, the 2012 we were looking at, since it's a repo, legally it has to be... we came this way, right? Yeah, we did. Legally it has to be taken to auction. So Aaron could not buy it, and now his butthole is so sore because he could not buy it. So... maybe one day, and it was perfect too, because it was a piece of crap, and you know that thing would have been mad cheap, but no. So, if you have a white hatchback 2012 STI that you want to sell our buddy Aaron here for next to nothing, please hit us up. And by next to nothing, I mean like $16,000. If it needs engine work, that's manageable. Unless it's blown. If it's a blown engine, I will give you $5,000 at max. Let's see. Yes. Well, anyway, that's our trip for today. What do you think about the new 2016 WRX?
It freaking sucks, man. It just sucks. It sucks so bad.
So, our assessment of the car, it is pretty quick. It looks good. Well, some of you might have different opinions about whether or not it looks good. But it's not very much of a driver's car. It's kind of numb. Like, it's quick. It just doesn't feel quick.
The seat of the pants dyno says it's slow. But yeah. I guess it is pretty quick.
Like, it gets up to 80 pretty fast.
Thing is though, between like 4,000 and 5,000 RPMs, it just dies. It just hitters out.
So, and I didn't really like the clutch feel of it. Let's see, what else did I not like? I'm not 100% sure, but it sounded like they were feeding engine noises through the
speakers.
And I was like, are you freaking kidding me? So.
When you start it, it makes the starting noise through the speakers.
Yeah, so I didn't really like that.
Hill assist.
Yeah.
Talk about that.
I think it might have hill assist. I'm not 100% sure because it felt like when you're on a hill, it didn't really roll back at all. So it might have a hill assist, and I'm not really a big fan of those. It was too refined for me. You know, it's not a rally car anymore.
It's like somebody said they want a car to commute to work in that's a little quick, just enough to give them a smile so they don't freaking blow their brains out.
It just felt like a fast commuting car is all it felt like. Not even fast, just like quick. But apparently it was developed on the Nürburgring, even though we didn't really get to take it on any corners. I mean, it handled from the one corner we got to take it on, which was in an off-ramp. It was okay, but
sounds good. Sounds really good.
Oh yeah, it does sound good.
Still got that nice Subi rumble.
Yeah, there'll be a clip of that in there too. But let's see, what else? My 1 to 10 rating on it, 10 being the best, I would list it as probably a 7. Maybe 6.5.
I'd give it a solid 6.
So, but also another thing. Oh shoot, I just lost my train of thought. Oh yeah, it does have a best in class power to weight ratio. So that's like with the Civic Si, the Golf, the GTI.
What about the Focus RS?
The Focus ST is not in that class. The Focus ST is in the class, but the RS is not. So it's faster than the Focus ST, but I think the RS is in the STIs class, so.
I think the RS will spank the STI.
Yeah, well.
345 to the wheels factory.
Yeah, so we'll see. I'm excited to see what the RS does.
We're gonna drive that next.
And then what Subaru does to try to top the RS, if they even do anything. They had the same motor in the STI for the past 12 years. So, that's all we have for that car. It was okay. I mean,
it's not very fast for 30 grand.
Yeah. You'd honestly be better off buying a used STI. So, hate us if you want, but
Just don't go to a dealership looking for a repoed STI, because you can't buy it.
Oh, yeah, so.
But who?
Yeah. That car was too pretty, and she couldn't buy it, so that sucked. But that's all we have for today. Alrighty, see you guys later.